and great turmoil in the mortal world. Souls from across the universe amassed to do battle, including my own son. All in service of a self-proclaimed god. An imposter who lays claim to the very creation of all. I have forbidden the gods from interfering in the affairs of mortals. Olympus must remain removed from the clamor below. But Kratos has shown what can happen when those not born of Olympus attain too much power. I will put a stop to this madness, and to anyone who dares stand in my way.
Ready? Fight! Duck! Block! Ready? Fight! Ready? Fight!
Destroy. Zircon is ready. Destroy. face, Mr. Zircon.
I grow weary of this.
Step up the volume!
Instrument of destruction.
Taking me in.
There's
a thing you might do about. Anyone up for some exercise?
A titan has spelled it for me, and so shall you.
Yeah, this will do. Plan B.
Man, 10 seconds left.
Fire.
3, 2, 1. I'm on.
With you,
I shall fight for what is mine.
Ready? Fight!
This is the handiwork of the Pretender. It looks like a mortal child's plaything. Is it you who has constructed this place?
Hey, I just got here myself.
A mortal? You dare raise your hand against a god? Explain yourself before I make you kneel.
I'm afraid I can't do that. I've seen too much happen too quickly around here.
Perhaps you thought I was making a request. Let me make myself clear! You will pay with your life for your insolence.
Victory! Ready?
Since I've been back to Olympus, I have restored order on Earth, where before there was only chaos. To do so, The most unruly of mortals had to be reminded of their place, and the so-called god stripped of his pretense. The threat posed by Kratos is real. It must be dealt with decisively. He must be made aware of the power that the gods of Olympus possess. And if he thought he would simply stride to Olympus, he will soon enough see what a mistake that is.